In this lesson, we will learn about classes in TypeScript in detail. Let's understand classes with examples. So here in my demo, in the app directory, I have created another file picture.ts and added some code to it. We will learn about classes from this file. I'll close this sidebar because we don't need it now. So here I have defined a class named picture. The syntax to define a class is to use the class keyword followed by the class name. And this entire piece of code is the body of the class. I have defined three field properties for the class: art title, owner, and price. Here I have used price with the underscore. You will know why. The definition of the field property uses the same syntax as we had seen in the interface. However, we can use the accessor methods, the getter and setter methods, to access and modify this property in the TypeScript class. Thus, they provide implementations which the interface don't. The class members can also have the access modifiers. We can use this to control the accessibility of the class members. By default, all the class members are public. However, you can explicitly use the public keyword as well, like I have done here for the art title. So here are the access specifiers: public, protected, and private. The protected members can only be accessed inside the class or any class that inherit from this class, whereas the private members cannot be accessed outside the class. So this was about the access specifier. Next, I have been telling about the accessor methods. This is the getter and setter method, which I am using to update the private member's price. Price is my private member here. These are basically like any general functions, except the get and set keyword that are used with the function. Here in the getter function, there is this get keyword in the function definition. The name of the function is the name of the property, price for me. The getter function should not take any parameter and return the value of the property underscore price here. Similarly, the setter method is defined with the set keyword with the name of the property as the function name. It takes one parameter. This parameter is the value to be assigned to the property. Here I am taking the parameter new price and storing it in the backing variable. This underscore price here is my backing variable which I am using for the private property. Now for a read-only property, we can just implement the getter and not the setter. For example here, if I make this price property read-only, here you can see I get the error in my setter method. So with the read-only modifier, the field cannot be assigned a new value in the setter method. For now, I'll remove it. Now, another thing to note here is the use of this keyword. To refer to a class member in a class, we need to use this keyword followed by a dot and the member name. Now, class methods are defined in the same way as general functions. One difference here is we don't use the function keyword in class method definition. So, like any other function, this is the order picture. It takes one parameter, returns void, and I have just added a log statement here for the demo purpose. So now we are familiar with the class members in TypeScript. Let me briefly show you something about the private fields in the TypeScript classes. Let's see here, if I create a new instance of a picture class, say new picture. Now here, this private specifier restricts the access of the members at the design time. We cannot access it from outside the class. So if I try to access this price property from outside the class, I won't be able to. I don't get the property in the list of options here. Even if I do it explicitly, I get an error. But now if I try to access it using the bracket notation in the TypeScript itself, I will be able to do it. You see, I get the option for the private property, and now I can assign a value to it. So this is called soft private in TypeScript. a private property can be accessible using the bracket notation in TypeScript. This can be a drawback, but this is helpful at times like unit testing. Also, after compilation in the output JS code, it will be a plain class property without access specifier. Hence, it can be accessed by any other piece of code. Now, to create a private field which won't allow any of such access in TypeScript or in JavaScript compiled code, we can define the variable to be hard private. To define a hard private property, I just need to add a pound sign in front of the property declaration. Let's say new price, which will be of number type. And now when I try to access the variable using any of these three ways, I'm not allowed to do it. Using the simple conventional method, or using the pound sign, or using the bracket notation. So this is a hard private declaration of TypeScript, and this keeps the property truly private. Now, what type of private we need to define the variable to be depends on the use of the code and the JavaScript runtime support. So this was basically an overview of class. We can simply define a class using the class keyword followed by the name. The body of the class is enclosed within the curly braces. We can define the class property with the access specifier. There are two types of private in TypeScript, soft private and hard private. We can also have the accessor methods in the class, the getter and setter methods, and then we define the methods of the class members like any other function but without the function keyword. We can also create new instances of the class. Let us now see how can we extend classes and implement interface.